Striving for optimal health, both inside and out. It's the High Plains Health Minute with Lacey Meeks.
It's amazing how much you can learn just by visiting with Lacey and Keith Meeks, Farwell Family Healthcare, Amarillo Family Healthcare. If you ever have a chance to have lunch with these guys, do it. It's a good opportunity to talk about health struggles and concerns. You'd be truly amazed to learn the effect that your hormones have on your daily life. And you hear that term all the time, guys. Hormones. Oh, I'm hormonal. It's a hormonal thing. It's hormones. Let's start there. What are hormones? It seems like such an all-encompassing thing.
They are. Hormones are chemical messengers that travel throughout the body, coordinating complex processes like growth, metabolism, fertility. They, in response to a signal from the brain, they're directly secreted from glands in the endocrine system. And we do throw this term around loosely a lot of times. My teenager is hormonal. My 5-year-old is hormonal. You know, that's not the kind of hormones we're necessarily talking about. And I think that we all know that there's good, bad, and ugly on hormones out there.
Right. And do hormones affect people of all ages? I mean, down to 3 years old, 4 years old, teenagers, things like that. Do hormones actually affect them?
We have hormones, you know, from in utero. Mm-hmm. I mean, they start making the uterus and the fallopian tubes and the ovaries and the testicles from the time the baby is in utero until they're born. They typically aren't activated until those kiddos are older. Mm-hmm. But we really see more hormone imbalance, you know, as we get into 25, 30-year-olds. Could you have thyroid imbalance at a younger age? Absolutely.
Hey, wait, I've seen plenty of 12-year-olds that are... Oh.
There's lots of hormonal teenagers out there. I said that. Once you get into the teenage years, once they kind of start their menses and things like that, they hit puberty. Yes, you're going to see those hormonal changes. And I'm sure some of you out there have lived through these hormonal changes.
I think what she was getting at is we're not necessarily looking to correct their hormonal issues.
Sure.
Until you may want to, but we're not necessarily ready to correct them until they get into their 20s.
Anybody who has raised teenagers through that stage know exactly what you're talking about. Is it different for men and women? Did men have different hormones than women? Do they have some of the same hormones? And do they react different in a man's body versus a woman's body?
Absolutely. And when I tell men that they have estradiol, they're like, I am not a woman. But you do have some estradiol, and it is important to have a little bit of estradiol. You have testosterone. You have thyroid hormone. You have a prolactin level. For women, we have estradiol, we have progesterone, we have testosterone, we all have serotonin, we all have cortisol, the stress hormone that we've talked about in the past, serotonin for our mood, for depression, for sleep, things like that.
And we have talked about some of those in the past. And I know over the next several episodes of the High Plains Health Minute podcast, we're going to dive a little bit deeper into some of the hormones that are out there. What are the key ones, though? What are the ones that you really watch for that really affect people on a day-to-day basis?
I really like to look at estradiol, testosterone in both men and women, progesterone in women, and thyroid. Thyroid is such a big one, you know, and our body does actually use vitamin D as a hormone. A lot of people don't realize that. And that's a whole podcast in itself to talk about vitamin D and how our body uses it and why is it important.
Is there such a thing? Is there truly such a thing as the perfectly balanced hormone, or is that the holy grail? Is that unattainable?
I think that's a loaded question. I think it depends on who you live with, whether or not you have the perfect hormone.
I noticed Keith has not said much in the past couple of minutes.
Well, he does live with, you know, three women or three girls. You know, we have a 2-year-old, a 5-year-old, and myself. So I'm sure there's some hormones in the house on occasion, but don't let him fool you that his hormones don't go crazy once in a while too.
Hey, I use her to keep mine optimal too.
Well, let's talk about that. Keeping your hormones optimal, or at least trying to achieve that optimal balance. Why is it so important?
Hormone imbalance can just lead to so many disease processes, to signs, to symptoms, to depression, mood swings, irritability, heart palpitations, decreased libido, sexual dysfunction, as you know, we've talked a lot about in both men and women. Hair loss, blood sugar changes can be related to hormones, belly fat, brain fog, infertility. And certainly I'm not the clinic for you for infertility. I can get you where you need to go. Mm-hmm. But those issues can go alongside it. And hormone balance, the protection of the brain, of the bones, of the breast, of the prostate with a optimal hormone balance is incredible. The studies
and there's a whole lot of difference when whoever you're seeing says your levels are normal. What is normal? Ask those questions to your provider.
And my theory is who the hell is normal?
Right.
You know?
Right.
I mean, really, who is normal? What is the definition of normal? I don't think any of us can give it that.
So if a healthcare provider tells you you're testing normal, it means you're falling within a range, but the
it's a range of people between 20 and 80.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Those are your ranges. So do you want to be normal 80 or do you want to be normal 20?
Well, and what levels did they check? What lab tests did they check? You know, did they check all the necessary hormone levels? That's another question that you need to be asking. And I want to be optimal. I don't want to be normal.
If you're seeing a provider that is only interested in estrogen or that is only interested in testosterone or only interested in your thyroid, find a new provider.
Well, I was going to ask you, that was actually the next question I was going to throw out there, because I'm not in the medical profession. I don't know. When it comes to men, are you primarily just looking at testosterone? When it comes to women, are you primarily just looking at estrogen?
Absolutely not. And again, you've got it with testosterone, even if you are on synthetic testosterone, which of course I am pro-bioidentical because it's what your body's always made. But we still should be checking estradiol levels. But we know how important thyroid is for cardiovascular health, for hair loss, for feeling cold, for fatigue, for brain fog, vitamin D for destroying cancer cells, for heart health. Vitamin D deficiency is an epidemic in our country in both men and women. If for bone health, there are so many things that if you're not treating that patient as a whole, we're failing you.
At your clinics in Farwell, at your clinic in Amarillo, you guys offer BioT, pellet therapy, to help balance hormone levels. What are patients realizing when they go through the BioT process?
So many times, years and years, they go, I've had my labs checked. They tell me I'm normal. Nobody listens to me. I don't feel normal. I'm not freaking normal, you know?
Yeah.
How do we correct this? You know, I chose BioT because they are superior to other pellet companies out there. They do have the research to back them. They are bioidentical. We've now, through the whole company of BioT, they've done over 1.7 million procedures.
My gosh.
Lacey's done over 7,000 procedures.
Right.
Ask your provider, whatever company they're using, whatever pellets they're using, how many procedures have been performed?
And what kind of results will patients see from BioT or pellet therapy? Or let's just talk even more general. If someone who's not currently a patient of yours at Farwell Family Healthcare or Amarillo Family Healthcare, and they go in and their healthcare provider recommends to them, hey, let's talk about hormone balancing. What can be the result if they get their hormones in better shape?
You know, your sex drive's better. Erectile dysfunction for men can be better. Irritability, mood swings, joint pain, muscle aches. So many times people have taken prescription sleep aids, myself included. For 10 years I took prescription sleep aids, and being on pellets, I don't have to do that anymore. Granted, not every night's beautiful. I have two children at home who don't sleep through the night. But as a general rule, I don't have to take prescription sleep aids anymore. And that's a huge benefit, because the side effects and the long-term effects of that prescription medication wasn't worth it for me.
Guys, is hormone balancing, be it through pellet therapy or you've heard of creams and injections and things of that nature, balancing out hormones or trying to reach balance of hormones, is that right for everybody or is it case by case?
Case by case, absolutely. It depends on the patient. What is your medical history? What are your levels? What other providers are you seeing? You know, do you have underlying mental health concerns that need to be addressed first?
Yeah, but if you haven't thought about it, if you're on injections, if your provider knows exactly what they're doing, you should be taking 104 injections a year. You should be doing it twice a week. That sounds exciting, yes?
Yeah. That's what I thought. Sarcastically,
or,
yeah.
Or they got you on creams. Look, I'm not saying creams are wrong for everybody, but how much is rubbing off on your clothes? How much is truly absorbing into your skin and doing its job? We don't really have the answer to that.
And the things that I've heard about before, and you guys will correct me if I'm wrong, someone's putting a cream on their wrist and all of a sudden they give their wife a hug and now all of a sudden you've
now
increased
their testosterone levels.
She has
up.
Issues, or your children or your animals. I mean, it really can wear off of them and cause hair in unwanted places in children. It's not good, you know, and even washing it down the sink, where is that going?
Let's talk about outside of pellet therapy, outside of the creams, outside of the injections. Are there things that people can change or do in their everyday life that might help with hormone imbalance?
Absolutely. And I've seen lab work change, you know, just changing up your diet, whether that is, do you have an autoimmune thyroid disease? Do you have an autoimmune disorder? Changing your diet, decreasing processed refined foods. Maybe it's gluten-free. And I hate that term because so many times gluten-free isn't healthy. Exercise, all of those things really play a role. You know, getting some sunshine does make a difference in vitamin D, but it really is more malabsorption on the vitamin D side in our part of the country now. We see vitamin D deficiency. Even people who drink whole milk, my farmers who are in the sun every day, we have issues with vitamin D.
Look, our foods have gone downhill to a point where 60% of the country is vitamin B12 deficient. The food is not what it once used to be. Even from the foods that are still grown in the ground, the soil is not what it used to be.
The nutrients
within the soil are not what they used to be.
And I would say in terms of the vitamins, you know, we're talking hormone imbalance, but we do know that vitamins and minerals also play a role in hormone balance. Fish oil, omega-3s really do help with hormone balance. So it's not just about hormones.
Activity level.
We have to also think about what else are we taking orally that are helping.
We weren't meant to be sedentary. We weren't meant to sit at computers for 14 hours a day. It starts with, you know, the kids do it. That's why they get obese or gain weight along with what they eat. But that's what the parents are doing all day. They're sitting in an office at work all day. There's not as many factory jobs as there used to be. It's just the way the world has gone. After work, you have to force yourself to go do something active. Do it with your kids, do it by yourself, whatever. But yes, that helps.
Not only, I mean, yes, there are factors that you can change to help with hormone balance, but there's also factors that you have no control, that are out of your control. Menopause being number one.
Mm-hmm. And let's talk about just briefly, if someone right now, they've downloaded the podcast, they're listening to it on their favorite platform, and they say, well, you know, I do find that I'm tired all the time. I have this fog. I can't describe it. I know that I don't have the mental clarity that I did even a year ago. There's just something going on. You said it a few minutes ago, Lacey, people will tell you, I just don't feel right. Something is just not right. Something is just off. What do you recommend? What do they do? How do they get started to find out if it is hormones?
For us, they schedule an appointment with the provider. We will see you for a medical visit. We will draw the necessary labs. We'll talk about that. There's no pressure. You don't have to make a decision the day you come in. If there's something underlying that needs to be treated, let's get it treated. Let's get you back on your feet. Let's get you feeling better. But let's also get those health benefits that we need from hormone optimization.
It's fascinating to know just how much those chemicals in your body can affect everything from your weight to your mood to your mental clarity. The list seems infinite. For that reason, striving for optimum hormone balance seems like a no-brainer. Over the next several episodes of the High Plains Health Minute, Lacey and Keith will dive deeper into the topic of hormones, a terrific opportunity for you to understand the different hormones in your body and how they affect your daily life. Just as important, how you can manage your hormones for a healthier you.
The High Plains Health Minute podcast provides general information and discussion about medicine, health, and related subjects. We make every attempt to provide accurate and up-to-date information, but medicine is an ever-changing landscape. The words and other content provided in this podcast are not intended and should not be construed as medical advice. If you have a medical concern, you should consult with an appropriately licensed healthcare provider. The information presented on this podcast are the host's personal views, opinions, and research on the subject matter.